अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहु। होप यू पीपल आर गुड। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट कम्यूटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी अंडर ऑल द फोर बेसिक ऑपरेशंस, दैट इज एडिशन, सब्ट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लिकेशन एंड डिवीजन। एंड वी हैव चेक्ड दैट कम्यूटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी इज सेटिस्फाइड बाई इंटीजर्स अंडर एडिशन एंड अंडर मल्टीप्लिकेशन। So here today in this video we are going to study about one more property, that is associative property. Okay, so what is the difference between associative property and commutative property? There is nothing. Just in as commutative property we are having two terms at LHS side and RHS side, but in associative property we are having three terms, that is ABC, whereas I said you before also, they are integers, and we are proving for integers. We are checking whether the integers are associative or not under all the four basic operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So today we are going to check whether whether integers are associative or not under addition. Okay, so let's begin with associative property. Associative property of addition. For integers, what are integers? Yes, exactly. Integers are nothing but set of positive, negative numbers including zero. Okay. So we are talking about associative property under addition, that too for integers. Okay, so first I would like to write general form. General form of commutative property under addition, have you remembered? What is that? Yes, exactly, that is a plus b equals to b plus a. So here, as I said you, one more term got extra here. One more term we are having in this associative property. And here also we are checking whether LHS and RHS are equal or not. If LHS and RHS both are equal, then we need to say that integers are associative under addition, because we are performing here addition operation. So we need to conclude the statement after simplifying complete problem. Okay. So general form is easiest way I will show you. So three terms I said you, because few people will get confused where to give the bracket, how to give the bracket and all. So simplest way is, first you need to write a plus b plus c at left hand side, similarly at right hand side also a plus b plus c. Now you are finding any difference? No, there is no difference. So what I have written here, a plus b plus c, and here also a plus b plus c. Then after that, what we have to do, first we need to give the bracket to the first two terms here and here to the last two terms. That's it. This is your associative property, general form of associative property. So how to read this? Pronunciation is also important, and how to read also very important. So this bracket is nothing but we are calling it as of. Okay. So a plus b of plus c equals to a plus of, this bracket is called it as of, a plus of b plus c. Why we have choose this addition operation? Because we are verifying for addition only. Okay, addition is there. Because of that reason, in complete expression or complete condition on both LHS side and RHS side, we are writing plus operation. Okay, so this is a general form. So first we need to take our own integers. Okay, here I will take my own integers and I will substitute. At your home you need to try by taking your own integers. Okay, so let, as I said you, integers are nothing but positive numbers, negative numbers including zero. So you can take any numbers here, positive, negative, zero, your wish. Okay, so I will take here a equals to minus 5, b equals to 8, one negative number I have chosen here, and one positive number c equals to 1, 0 I will take. Okay, because these are all belongs to the set of integers only. So all these values I have taken integers. Then first we need to take LHS. LHS stands for left hand side. Okay. What is the condition given at left hand side? Yes, exactly. It is given as A plus B of plus C. We need to replace this ABC by whatever the numbers I have taken here. Okay. So A is minus 5, B is 8. So plus 8. What is the value of C? 0. Okay. So first we need to give the solve the terms which are present within the brackets, because earlier also I have explained you, we need to follow the body mass rule. If an expression have more than one operation or brackets, at the time students will get confused. First we should subtract, add, multiply, divide, or what we should do. So easiest way is there, the body mass rule is there. Previously also I have explained you, this is stand, B stands for brackets and O stands for off, and D is division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. This is the way of giving the priorities. First we need to give the priority to the bracket terms. Whatever the terms present within the bracket, first we need to simplify that. After that we need to go for division, multiplication, addition. Then after last we have to perform subtraction. So as what we are finding here, we are not having different operations, only one operation is there, that is addition. And but we are having the bracket. So first we are going to simplify the terms which are present within the bracket. So we found that within the bracket we are having minus 5 plus 8. When there is a difference of signs, when there are different signs, at that time we need to do the subtraction. So exactly here we all, here also we have to do the subtraction. So minus 5 plus 8 is nothing but 3. As bigger number is plus, we have to write plus. Then plus, we are adding with third term, that is 0. So 3 plus 0, it remains 3 only. Okay, so 3. What is this? This is LHS. Okay, we got LHS as 3. Now the next thing we need to check out for RHS part. Okay, so here I will write RHS. RHS stands for right hand side. Okay, so what is the condition at right hand side? A plus of B plus C. Then we need to substitute the values, whatever we have taken as A, B, C. A is minus 5 plus B we have taken as 8, C as 0. Okay, so here also first we are giving the priority to the bracket terms. My 8 plus 0 remains 8 only. So minus 5 plus 8 is nothing but plus 3. So what is this plus 3? Yes, exactly, it is RHS. RHS value you got it as plus 3. So at LHS also we got 3 and RHS also we got 3. Both the side, what we are observing, they are equal. Is it clear, ma'am? So the most important today we are learning the one more property. For previously we have completed closure property and commutative property. Today we are going to study about associative property, that too associative property of addition. For which numbers? For integers. We can check out for whole numbers, we can check out for rational numbers also. But here we are checking out, we are verifying for integers. So what is the general form? General form is very, very important. Until and unless we don't know the general form, we are unable to simplify or we are unable to verify. So the general form is A plus B, this bracket is called it as of. So A plus B of plus C equals A plus of B plus C. This is the way. The what is the difference you are finding here, LHS side and RHS side? Yes, there is a difference of brackets. Here first two terms we are giving the bracket and right hand side we are giving the bracket to the last two terms. Based on the brackets only we are solving the problem. First we are solving to that particularly bracket terms. So ultimately what we have observed, that I will say you. So as general form we have written, we need to take our own integers. I have taken my own integers, you can choose your own integers. Minus 5 8 0, these are the values of ABC I have taken from the set of integers. Now first LHS part. LHS stands for left hand side, and left hand side, what is the condition? A plus B of plus c. So first we are going to solve this LHS part. Now I have substituted the values minus 5 plus 8 of plus 0, which is the value of c. Then and I have simplified and I got the result as 3. Okay, so LHS I got it as 3. Now after that I am checking out for RHS. So RHS is nothing but right hand side, and RHS side condition is a plus of b plus c, that I have written here. Then after that I have substituted the values and here simplification I have done, and ultimately I got the result as 3. So RHS side is also 3. So this LHS part and RHS part, what is happening? They both are equal, we have observed. So what we are checking actually, here we have observed that if we are changing the order of numbers, it means that here first we have added minus 5 and 8, but at RHS side first we are adding 8 and 0. Okay, the terms are same only, but we are changing their orders. First we are adding different numbers at LHS side and different numbers at RHS side. First we have added here minus 5 plus 8, then after that we have added it to 0. But here first we have added 8 and 0, after that whatever the result we got, that we have added to minus 5. Okay, so without irrespective of their order, we have checked that there is no change in the result, LHS side and RHS side. If we are changing the order of numbers also, we found that there is no change in the result. So that is called it as associative property. So commutative property also I have said that only if we are changing the order A plus B, B plus A. First we have to add A plus B, and right hand side we are adding B plus A. Both the sides we are changing the orders, but even though we are changing the order, after changing order whether the result is same or not, that we are verifying. So here we under addition we have checked for associative property, and we got that LHS and RHS both are equal. If they are equal, what we have to say? Yes, exactly, we need to say that LHS and RHS are equal. LHS equals to RHS. If they are equal, what is happening? Yes, they are, integers are associative. Okay, therefore integers are associative. Integers are associative under which operation we have done here? Under addition. Okay, hopefully this is clear to you people. So only simple few steps we need to check out. First we have to write associative property of addition, multiplication, whatever the operation you are performing, that too for integers. After that the most important thing we need to write the general form. General form is very very easy. Three terms are there, ABC, where this ABC I said you, they are the integers. Then we need to write the general form. After writing the general form, we need to take our own integers. If they have given in the question, you need to take that only. If they have not given, then we need to choose our integers. After that, LHS part separately we need to find out. Then RHS parts we need to simplify separately. After that, we need to check out whether they are equal or not. If they are equal, then integers are satisfying. If they are not, LHS RHS not equal, then integers are not satisfying or not verifying. Fine. So next we are going to check associative property of multiplication. Okay, addition and subtraction inshallah in the next video we are going to check out. So associative property of multiplication. Just now we have completed addition. Now we are checking out for multiplication. Multiplication for integers. So here the operation we are checking out for multiplication, and the numbers are integers. Okay. Three things are important: associative property, operation is multiplication, and the numbers we have taken are, we are going to take, or we are taking are integers. So first again we need to write the general form. General form I said you very easily. Yes, three terms with multiplication operation a into b into c. Both the sides a into b into c. But the changes are first we need to give the brackets to the first two term and right hand side we have to give the bracket to the last two terms. Now after that we need to choose our own values. Let a equals to, okay fine, a is equals to 9 I will take, b equals to minus 2, c equals to minus 1. These are the three different integers I have choose from the set of integers. Now immediately what I said after writing general form and taking a, b, c values, yes, we need to go for the LHS part. What is LHS stands for? Left hand side. And what's the condition? A into b into c. A value, b values and c. All these three values we need to substitute in this condition. What we have choose here. So 9 into minus 2 into minus 1. Okay. So first we need to give the priority to the bracket term. So I am solving this part first. So here first we need to multiply the signs. Here there is no sign, it means the number is positive. So plus minus. So plus into minus is minus. Then we need to multiply the numbers. 9 into 2 is nothing but 18. Yes. Into minus 1. Okay. Fine. So this minus here, again both the numbers are negative here. So minus into minus, again it will give plus. So 18 times of 1 is, you will get 18 only. Plus 18 you got. This is your LHS value. If you are writing plus or not, there will be no effect in the result. All the most of the time we will not write the positive sign, because if there is no sign also, the number is always positive itself. The next thing we need to check out for here, RHS part. What is RHS stands for? Yes, right hand side. And what is right hand side condition is given? Yes, a into of b into c. Now we need to substitute the values of a, b, c. A is 9, b is minus 2, c is minus 1. See here, first we are multiplying the bracket terms. Within the bracket terms we are having minus 2 and minus 9, minus 1. Whereas in case of LHS part, the terms which were present in the bracket are 9 and minus 2. So first we have simplified that. But here RHS side we are having minus 2 minus 1. Into minus it gives plus. 2 times of 1 is 2. Now this is also positive, this is also positive. When both are positive we'll get positive only. So plus into plus we'll get plus. If you want to write plus sign, or if you don't want to write, there is no issues. So 9 twos are, yes, 9 twos 18. So what is this 9 times of 2 is 18. This is the RHS value. So RHS right hand side you got it as 18, and LHS part you got it as 18. Okay ma, understood everyone? So associative property of multiplication. Here the operation we have chosen is multiplication, and the numbers are, for which numbers we are verifying? For integers. The general form is similar with addition only. Okay, associative property under addition. The only the changes we have to do is, we have to change the operation. In place of addition we are replacing this with multiplication. Remaining everything is same. After writing general form we need to choose our own integers. After taking the integers, first we need to simplify LHS part, then after that RHS part, as I simplified over here. So LHS part and RHS part, after simplification again we observe that without irrespective of their orders we got the result as same. Okay, so when they are same, LHS part and RHS part, what we are going to say? Yes, exactly, we have to say that integers are associative. Okay, integers are associative under multiplication. So here we are going to write that only, LHS equals to RHS. When LHS equals to RHS, therefore what is happening? Integers are associative. Okay, integers are associative. Under which operation we have checked here? under multiplication. Is that clear, my everyone? So today we have studied about associative property of addition and multiplication. Inshallah, in the next video we are going to study about associative property. The left out two operations are there, that is subtraction and division. So we are going to verify in the next video whether the integers are associative or not under subtraction and division. Hopefully the concept is clear to you people, and by taking your own integers you can check out whether they are verifying whether they are associative or not, integers are associative or not under multiplication and under addition. Okay, jazakallahul khair, thank you.